Malo, Anthony.
Hey, Uncle Johnny. Well, I would say I'm all right too, but that's not exactly true, you know. Because, I got this little personal note here. I got a little garden in the back, you know, and, you got to kick the fork spinning, you got to till the thing and whatever have you. And, you know, it's not, I got some kale growing pretty nice, you know. But you see, I'm a writer, you know, not a fighter, or, you know, so I'm fighting the earth to, you know, put the fork spade in, right? And I kept on doing that. And I'm just getting blisters. I'm getting callous on my right hand. You can't see it now, but I feel it. So I gotta get my construction gloves to do this next time. I wasn't thinking when I was going all out, you know, shuffling and stuff like that. Anyway, the kale's growing, so it's fine. But you know, talking about struggle, because that's a struggle working with the earth like that. Here's what I've been thinking, I've been struggling. I've been in struggle a lot of my life. Like for instance, I'm not going to early stuff, but let's say, I think it was 1968, 67, somewhere around there, when this guy, this southern racist guy, governor of Georgia or wherever, Mississippi or Arkansas or whatever those places down there, George Wallace, you know, this guy, you know, he's running for president, so we was protesting, you know, up there in Madison Square, came to Madison Square Garden for a big rally, we was protesting, and they brought the horses. It's not that field, there's big horses trying to control the crowd and stuff like that. No, I don't see horses in the crowd much more. I guess they figured out if you bring a horse on the pavement and you throw some ball bearings there, the horse will fall or whatever happens to them. I guess that's what figured out. Because now you know what they got. They got tanks and stuff like that. You know, they got machines that make you deaf and stuff like that. To control the crowd, they don't want people to protest or talk about stuff. So they militarize, as they say. They militarize stuff. Even right now in Lesotho, you know, there's a big thing in Lesotho because, you know, they formed a coalition government and the guy said, oh no, we ain't doing that. The people's gonna go protest, and he started to try to militarize the police to stop the protest. What's going on here, all this protest? But see, here's the thing. Here's what I figured. And I hate to bring it up, but, well, South Africa, for instance, you know, there used to be different kinds of protests. Like, there's a guy that just passed. What's this one? I got him right here. But can you just hold this for just a second while I get the page here? I wrote it down. Oh, turn right to it. Take that right back. That was quick that time. But, you know, the Bishop David Patrick Hamilton Russell. Now, he was the bishop, the priest, you know, the clergyman that was in Dimbaza when they used to dump everybody in Dimbaza, came from Robin Hood, just dumped in Dimbaza, nothing there. They had to, you know, they made a famous movie, Last Grave at Dimbaza, about all the kids that died and stuff like that. But this guy, what he did, he was trying to tell people to play with these folks. So what he did is he started living like them. He lived in the community. He existed on something like back then, it was like 14 rands a month for a whole family. He was just one person. And he started living like that. He lost a lot of weight. He went back to his people and said, look, hey, see what's going on. That was a protest. You know, he was showing people. I tried to do what they did, but a whole family could do it. Look, I'm losing weight and everything like that. Anyway, he brought light to that area and changed all that. But he had this thing. He had to say, he just passed last week, a couple of weeks ago. He had his dictum, they call it his dictum, you know, his saying, his mantra, if you will, was always have a cause. Bishop Russell said that. Bishop David Patrick Hamilton Russell, he said, always have a cause. That's very interesting. I'm listening to that. You know, because here's what I'm saying. I realized that I've always struggled. You know, after that, with the powers, you know, with black arts movement, with anti-apartheid, you know, with my placards in the street and stuff like that. But you know, when I'm not picking South Africa exactly, but when y'all got your freedom, or when we hope South Africa's their freedom, what'd they do? They're laid back. They don't have no more causes. There's other people in the world that now needs that energy to be free. I mean, personally, you know, I can keep on going because There's one I'm attached to. I told you before about Red Cloud, one of my heroes, one of my people that I look at almost like Bishop Russell. You know, Red Cloud beat the American army. You know, but he come from the Lakota Nation. Now, right now, I saw this chart. Do you realize the suicide rates? Here's how they go. The highest rate of suicide, just talking about the states, not to talk about, you know, where I come from. American Indians, male, highest suicide rate. The next is, they say whites. The next thing is like Hispanic or Latino, then black and Asian. But the highest is the American Indian. Mm. That means that they're in the most trouble to me. So my cause, the cause I always have, is to address and to, I don't want to say free, but help in the upliftment or the freedom of the Lakota Nation. And because they're not free, I got to keep on going. No matter where I am, I'm struggling with this area or that area, just to help practicing my struggle, practicing my cause, because my ultimate cause is everything is free, the Lakotas will be free. And when the Lakotas are free, since they're in the worst shape, I figure everything else before them. But this is only an idea I just have. I mean, I could be wrong. But you know, sometimes you're right, sometimes you're wrong. But you gotta keep on struggling. You gotta always have a cause. Mm-hmm. Understand that? Now I understand it. And I understand it because this is a dispatch of understanding, a dispatch from the ArtsDirector Emeritus. That would be me, T, from the Patterson's, taking the train to Tibet, letting you know what I own this is.